Coming up, I'll walk you through Microsoft communication compliance, not generally available. This proactively surfaces careless or negligent communication that may put your organization at risk, so that you can identify, investigate, and stop inappropriate conduct as soon as possible. Of course, communications are a vital part of your everyday business, so our approach to communication compliance is one of trust, but verify. This means by giving you the right visibility, processes, and controls to detect and mitigate inappropriate conduct while aligning to the cultural, legal, and privacy requirements in which you operate. To be effective, you need to be able to quickly catch communication violations at scale to prevent financial or negative impacts on both your employees and your organization. In fact, getting this right can help you mitigate insider risk and support a healthy company culture. This is where Microsoft Communication Compliance helps. An evolution of Office 365 supervision capabilities, where we made a number of improvements to help you detect, investigate, and remediate violations. You get to communication compliance from the solution catalog in Microsoft Compliance Center. Here you can see our compliance solutions organized in three areas: information protection and governance, insider risk management, discovery and respond. I'll select communication compliance under insider risk and open the solutions. As you can see from our dashboards, we give you a holistic view of communication that matches your policies. You can see policies that have triggered recent alerts, a trend line of recent policy matches, as well as how many of those have been triaged by my reviewers. Next, on the bottom, I can see which policy historically have highest number of matches, and I can quickly see the top users associated with policy matches, as well as the number of escalations. One thing to note here is that this dashboard is an indicator of the number of policies that have been matched. It's not always an indicator of policy violations, as this requires further investigations with your reviewers. Now you can imagine the volume of data you would have to query to get an assessment like this. Behind the scenes, we use machine learning to reason over a huge volume of signals generated by send and receive emails and team conversations to discover and surface the incidents that you care about, measuring things like sentiment for intent or other anomalous behavior like non-compliant communications. We've also configured email alerts so that you can be notified when a high number of matches occur that need your attention. For example, here I'm being flagged for offensive language matches in my organization. When I click on the email, I can quickly get a view of the incidents. When I can investigate further, for example, here I can see a communication violations flag within this user's Teams conversation. The first check I can do is see if this user has a history of violations, and we can quickly see that this user has one other offense. Now I can take action. In this case, I'll send an email notification reminding the user of our corporate policy and a link to our training. I'll choose from our pre-configured notice templates, leave the defaults, and hit send. We've had built-in intelligence to detect profanities for a while, but we've now expanded the offensive language classifiers with built-in intelligence to identify threat to others, or even for the individual to harm themselves, or even targeted harassment, which is where built-in sentiment analysis really kicks in to find the intent of communication based on the tone of what is being said. Now let's switch gears and show you a different scenario where we need to have a communication policy in place to fulfill regulatory compliance. I'll go back into policies and select insiders. In this example, we've detected a violation related to the US FINRA regulation, which requires organizations to monitor things like insider trading. Here, we're looking for keywords and expressions such as credit card or bank routing number. Also, beyond the actual message of an email or chat conversation in Teams, we know that violations can show up in the attachments that are sent. Not only you can view the content sent in line without needing to download it, but we've added keyword highlighting so that you can quickly hone in on inappropriate communication, speeding up your review. I can also look at third-party sources that the system has flagged. To see that, I'll add a filter, click on item class, and select instant Bloomberg messages. I can even go further by investigating related communications through capabilities called near duplicate, which flags similar message sent. This helps me to quickly detect patterns of related behavior. And now if I want to, I can escalate this incident to other reviewers via email. I'll pick a Dell, provide a reason, and hit escalate. If this was a severe violation, I could also create a case with the violation, give it a name, provide a reason, and this will go directly to the legal team to investigate. Now let's switch gears to show you how easy it is to create a policy. I'll go back to the Policy tab, and in this case, select Custom Policy. Now you can see the key steps articulated on the left. First, I'll provide a name. Next, I'll choose users or groups to supervise, as well as the reviewers for this policy. Choose your reviewers. Choose the communication locations to monitor. As I showed you earlier with the Bloomberg example, you can also supervise non-Microsoft communications. I'll start by adding a condition. This gives me a list of options. I'll select classifiers. And from here, I can pick from built-in classifiers such as harassment or threat that you saw in our offensive language policy. Or you can build your own data classifiers, such as the one I have here for customer complaints or privacy breach. If you want to build a classifier, you can do so in the Compliance Center under Data Classifications. To learn more, you can visit ak.ms/data-classifiers. Additionally, you can also set your conditions based on your own dictionary of terms by creating your own sensitive information types or by using the ones we give you. Back in the policy, once you are done specifying your conditions, you can select the percentage of communications you'd like to review with this slider. For example, regulatory compliance, you might want to scope to only 10% matches, whereas for corporate policy, you might want to expose 100% of communications since you might have zero tolerance. And from there, you can review your policy settings, hit Create Policy, and voila, you are done. So that was an overview of the new communication compliance solution in Microsoft 365. We are continuously innovating based on your feedback to bring you the most comprehensive solution, and you'll see ongoing updates in areas like more templates, improved remediation workflows, and additional insights. To learn more, you can go to ak.ms/communicationcompliance. Thanks for watching.